everyone, this is Aishwarya and welcome to Beauty with Coach. So guys, today we are going to learn about bitwise operation. Okay, or bitwise operator rather. So what is bitwise operation? See, operations which we perform on one or more bit pattern. Okay, bit pattern. So in simple language, operation which we perform on binary numbers. Okay, it's called bitwise operator. Okay, so this is actually a concept of digital electronics or digital logic. So yes, and what is bitwise operator? See, operators which we require to perform bitwise operations are bitwise operators. Okay, so stay tuned if you want to know about it, and please watch this video till the end. Okay, and after that, if you think it's helpful, it's informative, then please don't forget to share it as much as possible. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon next to it. So with this note, let's get started with bitwise operations. So x is equals to 12 and y is equals to 6. First operator is AND operator. First of all, why this BIN? This is because I want my output in binary. Okay, if you don't want your output in binary representation, just remove this BIN part. Okay, then you have to give only this x and y. Okay, so it's up to you. You can do anything. Okay, and what is this? X and y. So this is AND operator or bitwise AND operator, and x and y, these are operands because operation is being performed on them. Next, OR operator. So x and y again operands, and this is AND operator or bitwise AND operator. Next, exclusive OR or XOR operator. So this is exclusive OR operator. Okay, next, NOT operator. See, for NOT operator, we don't need two operands. We need only one operand to perform NOT operation. Why? Because NOT operation is supposed to convert 0 into 1 and 1 into 0. Okay, next is shift operator. So two types of shift operators are there, left shift operator and right shift operator. So first, left shift operator. So you can see arrow pointing towards left, isn't it? So just keep this in mind. So this is left shift operator. So also bits of x, or these are bits, isn't it? So bits of x is supposed to be shifted leftward by y. And what is y? 6. Okay, so this from here we will start. So this will shift 6 unit left. Okay, 6 unit left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so this 0 will come here. And same thing. Okay, don't worry, I'll make everything visible by running the program. And now right shift operator. Same thing, but here this will move this side. Okay, this will move rightward. So just run the program to see what's happening here. See, y is 0b because things are represented in binary. That's why 0b. Okay, y 100 AND operator. See, 00 will return 0. 01 will represent 0. 11 will represent 1. So 001. 10 will represent 0. So 0. And after that, all zeros are there. So 000. Okay, so no need. That's why. Again, come to AND operator or AND operation. So 00 is 0. Okay, let's do this. Okay, sorry. Yeah, so 00 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 1, and after that 0 0. Okay, so I'm not going to explain everything, but yes, you can check the output. Okay, so this one is XOR, again NOT, and then left shift and then right shift. Okay, so these are the operators which we perform. Okay, so I hope you understood everything.
So I hope you understood about bitwise operator. Now, as a bonus, you may say, I want to discuss a topic which I actually forgot to discuss before. I should have discussed it earlier, but I forgot. So don't worry, we'll discuss it today. So let's move to functions. User defined functions.
So DEF. DEF represents define. Okay, so since we are defining this function, that's why we used DEF. Okay, now add. What is add? Add is nothing but name of function. Okay, you can give whatever name you want. X and y are parameters or the formal parameters. We don't even know their value, but we want our function add to return summation of x and y. Okay, so these are formal parameters, and we want add
to return x plus y. That's why return. Okay, now a equals to 5, b equals to 5. So we know the value of a and b. So these can be user defined value, these can be fixed value, whatever you want you can take. Okay, so yes, these are actual parameters because we don't want summation of x and y, we want summation of a and b, isn't it? So we passed a and b into this function add, and now we want to print. That's why print. Okay, so let's run the program to see. See, it has returned 10, isn't it? Why? Because a plus b or 5 plus 5 is equals to 10. I hope you understood.
So today we discussed about bitwise operation as well as user defined functions, and I hope you understood everything. If no, then do let me know in comment section, and if yes, share it with your friends as much as you can. And if you're new to my family, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and bell icon next to it. So with this note, I'm wrapping up this video. So stay healthy, stay fit, and this is Aishwarya signing off. Bye bye bye. Love you all.